Good Sunday evening, everybody. Live and direct from downtown Memphis, Tennessee. I'm meteorologist Austen, Onek with a quick check of your forecast. Of course, the NFL, the championship game with the Patriots taking on the Chiefs on our main channel for right now. And we're going to be on a little bit later than usual. Again, with the end of the game coming up a little bit later on. Not exactly certain when at this point, but again, please stay tuned and we'll have a forecast update for you sometime around or after 10 o'clock tonight. But if you can't stick around for the whole thing, that's cool because, again, we've got a good opportunity for you to learn more about what's going on with the weather as we finish up the holiday weekend going into tomorrow and looking at some much nicer conditions into the area briefly before we start changing things around again. Got a lot of ups and downs in the near future. We'll talk more about that coming up in just a little bit. Never been here before. Again, welcome to our online netcast to give you an idea as to what's happening. Got questions about the forecast? That's great. We'll give you a generic overall idea. I can't really do individual city forecasts specifically because that's just going to take far too long. So we'll give you an update as to what's going on. If you can't stick around for the whole thing, that's cool too. Take a look at the blue bar scrolling by here at the bottom portion of your screen, and you can read more about what's going on with the forecast. Also, you can catch up with the forecast here at WREG.com/weather. It is going to be a chilly one into and around the area tonight for the lunar eclipse, which as of right now, again, is not started just yet, but it will be within about another half an hour or so. If you've got pictures, we'd love to see them. If you'd love to send them to us on social media, I'd love to feature them as well. So if you got them, please send them along, and we'll talk more about that coming up here in just a little bit. Welcome to everybody tuning in. Drop your location and your weather reports into the comments section. Let's see where you're from, city, state only. Don't need the whole mailing address, but thank you very much for sending that along. And into, again, the area for tonight, wherever you're at, going to be looking at some more potential for some chilly conditions going into Monday morning. Overnight low temperatures dropping into the lower to mid-20s with, again, a few clouds out there passing on through. Nothing huge, not overcast, thankfully, for, again, this time of the year. We could be getting a lot more clouds and a lot more snowfall, but that is definitely not what is happening at this point in time. Scott Jarvis, Banner, Mississippi, I'm assuming, 31 degrees, light winds from the north at about 4 miles per hour. Let's see. Austen, it's freezing. Where's the snow? Bridget Latrice Maxwell, gone for now, but just hang on for a second on that one. Grady Bennett, welcome to the show. 26 degrees in Berclair. Thank you very much for that. Jeff Stroud, welcome from Brighton. And Alonzo McClinton, welcome from South Haven. Welcome to everybody who's tuning in for tonight. Ronnie Williams, 28 degrees in Collierville. Welcome to the show. High temperature today, only 34 degrees, way below normal for this time of the year, so a powerful push of cold air dropping into the mid-south area. Dry officially, we are just about normal for this time of the year on precipitation, but way below normal on the temperatures out there on the weather almanac for the day. Our nation's capital, again, a lot quieter after a latest winter storm moved on through. A little bit of rain, a little bit of snow earlier, 24 degrees, looking at the National Park Service's webcam across the Potomac River and toward the monuments and the United States Capitol building there in the background. Moon up above. Unfortunately, this is as far upwards as we can pan our Shelby Farms Park camera, but some good viewing for tonight outside of a few clouds. Again, the lunar eclipse beginning in just about a half an hour or less, so we should be seeing, again, some hopefully good conditions out there for viewing. More information about when to look and what to look for, head to my Facebook page or Twitter page out there. You do not need glasses for this eclipse. A solar eclipse, that's a different story. Lunar eclipse is just sunlight bouncing off the lunar surface and is not a danger like you would be staring at a solar eclipse like we had a couple of years ago. Back to West Memphis, Arkansas. Traffic on I-40, I-55 moving along downtown Memphis out there on the horizon, and a chilly evening as well, with numbers back in the mid to upper 20s into and around the area for tonight. Kevin Potts, 32 between Oxford and Batesville. Welcome to the show. Dana Franks Tally, not liking the cold weather. I think that's a common sentiment out there for right now. Paulette Anders, 27, clear and cold in Bartlett. And Jacob Newman, also a vote for warm weather out there. Thank you very much for that one. A lot of people waiting for the warmer conditions out there. Melinda Gail Cook, if I'm saying that right, two-point typeface and bifocals, bad combination here. 23 degrees, That sounds about right for Water Valley, Mississippi. Thank you very much. And Trey Harris, cloudy and 25 in Gleason, Tennessee. Don't think I've ever been there before. Storm Tracker 3S radar, clean sweeps across much of the area, but we do have some passing snow showers from around Kansas City, St. Joseph, all the way back to Middle Tennessee. The area that you see here in the purple, I'm going to get rid of the cloud cover for just a second, focusing on just the snow showers back to our north and east, maybe picking up a flurry down toward the ground. We're just not really looking at too much of anything in the way of accumulation. This is remnants on the backside of that last system that moved on through the area. Now, more importantly for tonight, getting rid of the snow and taking a look at just the cloud cover on the satellite picture, you can see the clouds out there dropping into and through the Mid-South area, so there may be some passing clouds out there that obscure the eclipse from time to time. Hopefully not a big problem, but most of that in West Tennessee, Western and Central Kentucky, and Middle Tennessee picking up some of that, and a few stray clouds around portions of eastern Arkansas, but again, hopefully good viewing out there for later on tonight. Cold in Cherokee Village, Arkansas. Virginia Sandlin Wiles, thank you very much for that one. Jennifer Bennett, we'll take a look at Dyersburg and the rest of the Mid-South here in a little bit. Shonda Marie Bridges, the eclipse begins in about 25 minutes or so as the penumbra eclipse shadow, the lighter of the two eclipse shadows, makes its way across the lunar surface. We'll talk about that coming up here in just a little bit. For right now, see Kelly Hunter Lowe still waiting on the February snow. Going to be waiting a little bit longer. We'll talk about that coming up, but maybe not too long. East Memphis, Ron Buck, Colonial Acres, 30 degrees. Thank you very much for checking in from there with more information on that. Martin, Tennessee, moon rising. Bud Thornley, welcome to the show there. Chilly out there tonight. Again, if you're going out for eclipse viewing, going to need to bundle up as wind chills in the far right-hand column on WeatherNet 3 are going to be way down into the teens. They were in the single digits, almost below zero this morning in parts of the area. And if you like this information from WeatherBug on your computer system, go to this website, WREG.com/weather, and click on the WeatherNet icon to find out more about what's going on there. News Channel 3 at 10, thereabouts, depending on when the NFL gets finished up. Mid to upper 20s, and the winds turning out of the north-northeast. And again, a few cloud cover areas around Tennessee, but not much of anything else in the way of moisture out there. Now, through tomorrow morning, the holiday coming up for Martin Luther King Jr., honoring of him for tomorrow. A lot of groups out and about trying to make the Mid-South a better place, picking up trash, doing home repair for the elderly, whatever's going on. Again, the spirit of Dr. King, looking again at some dry conditions, cold as they start off the morning hours. But as we get into tomorrow afternoon, a little bit warmer than today. At least we'll have some sunshine and no major inclement weather coming through, all of which we can get at this time of the year. So through tomorrow afternoon, temperatures back in the mid-40s at best, but that's not the 30s that we saw today. And then through tomorrow night, dry with temperatures back in the mid-upper 30s by News Channel 3 at 10. Now through tomorrow, again, mostly sunny, clear, dry, and decently chilly. Warmer than today by about a category, but still below normal for this time of the year. Tuesday is going to warm up and be the warmest day of this entire forecast. From here on out, we get some pretty chilly numbers over the next several days. Not exactly Arctic blast territory, but again, we'll see some pretty chilly conditions into and around the area. Wade Mitchell, any snow for Batesville Wednesday night? Talk about that in just a little bit. Thank you for that. Likewise, Channing Kidd, stay tuned for more there. And Kim Cantrell Keohane, hope I'm saying that correctly. Harmontown, Mississippi. Beverly Miles, thanks a lot for joining us. And Kim Cantrell Keohane, how cold in the morning. Temperatures tomorrow will be back in the lower to mid-20s out across much at the area for tomorrow, so definitely going to bundle up for that. The chances of rain, looks like they're going to hold off until about roughly dinner time on Tuesday afternoon and evening, pretty much. Again, coming home from work or school, could be some showers there. Showers will continue as we go into Wednesday, and then there's going to be a slim chance for the metro area. This forecast here is mainly based for, again, the Memphis I-40 area, the I-40 corridor, north, maybe a few degrees cooler, south into Oxford, northern Mississippi, southeast Arkansas, a few more degrees on this, but this is kind of your baseline forecast out there for the metro. And again, temperatures by the time we hit Wednesday, cooling off again into the lower 40s. Getting to about afternoon and evening, the temperatures start to slide, and that's where we start to see, again, the possibility of some rain-snow mixture in the area. This one does not look like a blizzard situation or a major winter threat for now. Again, we'll be watching that carefully over the next few days. Thursday, again, clearing out the rain and the snow and everything that should not last much past about mid-evening on Wednesday. Thursday doesn't look like much, clearing out a bit and maybe a degree or two cooler. Much cooler for Friday as another punch of cold air rolls on through. But we're seeing another chance of some rain, possibly rain mixed with snow on Saturday into Sunday. Again, this one does also not look to be a major threat. Some precipitation frozen, but just not a huge chance of really anything happening just yet. But hang on to that thought for just a little bit. Rest of the week, again, pretty chilly, 30s and 40s for highs only. So again, Tuesday, warmest day of the week coming up right now. Now, toward the end of the forecast, several models are starting to hint at something a little bigger out there, possibly heading our direction. And again, taking a look at way down the line, 10 days out, it's kind of like looking from Memphis across the river to West Memphis, Arkansas, and seeing a semi-truck on the horizon. But as it gets much closer to you, you get to see all the details on it, like the forecast. Now, again, toward about the end of the month, looking at colder temperatures by about Wednesday, and maybe the possibility of some more rain, possibly cold enough for some snow out there. Again, a little iffy for right now because it's so far in advance at this point in time. But if you have any plans toward about the 30th and afterwards into February, we might be seeing something more significant heading our way. But as I say, again, it's well far to the distance. So this is something that just needs to be watched. So keep it tuned to News Channel 3. Keep it tuned to our website and on air. And we'll keep you updated on everything going on. But between here and there, the best chances for snow on Wednesday afternoon and evening. And again, Saturday and Sunday, possible, but just not great chances out there for right now. So that's about as good as it gets for the time being. You still have time to make your way out to Kennan Observatory on the Ole Miss campus. They'll be starting their viewing in Oxford, Mississippi. Again, that'll be coming up starting at 9:30. That's about an hour and 15 minutes from now. And the Memphis Astronomical Society is setting up right now at Shelby Farms Park. And you can find more about that by going to their website at memphisastro.org, or you can go to their Facebook page, or you can go to my Facebook page, which has all this information listed on it about what's going on and where you can observe stuff for tonight. Going to be chilly out there, no question about that. Again, the eclipse roughly begins in the total phase out there. There's going to be two shadows that you're going to see, the lighter shadow called the penumbra, and then the darker shadow called the umbra. That's going to be moving its way on through, and you'll start to see the Earth's shadow covering the moon at roughly about 9:30 or so. Totality, as it just covers over the entire lunar surface, will be happening at about 11:12 for this evening, just before midnight. And right after that, the darker portion of the moon's the Earth's shadow moves away, and it goes back to being the bright moon after that secondary lighter shadow moves away. But here in about the next about 15 to 20 minutes, you're going to start seeing the moon darker and a little bit more red. It's going to be called a blood moon because of that. And that is also going to be seeing again happening again here pretty soon. So this is going to be a great show, good opportunity to get you or your kids interested in a little bit more about astronomy, and a good opportunity to see what's going on out there for tonight. But once again, bundle up, because we're talking about some pretty cold conditions out across much of the area for this evening. Thanks to everybody for some great pictures. Thanks to Sherry B. Ware for passing along information from the National Weather Service. If you've got pets and they're outdoors, they have to be protected with what is called adequate shelter. If you don't have that, that can be considered a misdemeanor offense. Some states, it's a felony. So again, please make certain your pets are taken care of. If you see neglect going on, document it. A good place to start will be the Memphis and Shelby County Humane Society that works with the Shelby County Sheriff's Department to track cases of this. I've worked with them before on stuff like this, so thank you very much for passing that along. And please make certain all your pets outdoors have, again, adequate shelter. Snow and dusting in Drummond's, Tennessee this morning. 23 degrees from J.P. Rockin. Thank you very much for that one. A. Butler, 1967. Beautiful view this morning. looking back toward Venus, Jupiter, and Antares, the star. Two planets and a star. Nice capture for the morning hours. That captured from Jonesboro, Arkansas. Thank you, Mr. Butler, on that. And Mississippi County Office of Emergency Management. Some snow in the backyard and also on the barbecue grill. So thank you very much for that. Pictures to share, hopefully, of the eclipse. Drop them to me again at Twitter at Aonic_WREG3. On Facebook, on Instagram, or again, if you can't do any of that, but you still have access to email, you can email me at austen.onek@wreg.com. Would love to have you dropping that off. My forecast throughout the rest of the weekend on Country 92.5 and Oldies 102.3. Our weather app is available to keep you informed out there. And also, I'll be back on live with Bob and Josh Tuesday morning, 6 to 8 a.m. AM 730 and 1600 sports chat for the Mid-South and a lot of it going on. And again, you can access that as well online at talkbacklivenetwork.org. And also the new episode of Your Environment, our online environmental ecological blog, will be posted tonight. And you can get more details about what we're focusing on this week, including how you can participate in citizen science. That'll be available at wreg.com/weather/environment if you want to find out more about that there. That'll do it for this edition of News Channel 3's video weather blog, Weather Overtime. Again, we'll be on late tonight. It looks like we're somewhere in the third quarter. Not too sure who just scored, but again, the NFL championship game going on there. So we'll be a little later tonight than right at 10 o'clock. So join us for the late edition and especially make certain to stay tuned for Todd Demers' forecast and Corey Ventura's traffic reports that'll be coming up bright and early tomorrow morning on News Channel 3 Daybreak. Again, the eclipse just will be starting here in just about another 15 minutes as that lighter shadow crosses on through, and the darker shadow, the secondary shadow called the umbra, that'll be passing over the moon's surface starting in about an hour and 15 minutes. So you got plenty of time to get out there and take a look at it, but bundle up. It's going to be a cold one out there, so please keep an eye on temperatures out there, especially if the kids are out going out taking a look for that. And again, great evening to do some stargazing out there. Stay tuned for more with News Channel 3 on air and online. And thanks to everybody for dropping by for our latest edition of our online video weather blog, Weather Overtime. Stick around for a lot more at wreg.com/weather.